guys, Mr. Kiye, and as far as the specs on the Y7P are concerned, the major drawbacks are the fact that you are getting HD display, there's a micro USB port, and yeah, there's no gyroscope sensor on this guy, and also there's no OIS. But on the plus side, you're getting a 48MP triple camera setup at the back that is backed by AI, and an 8MP front camera. And guys, they do take pretty good pictures. I love the fact that the pictures look true to life, and by that I mean there's no unnecessary color reproduction. The highlights are also kept in check, and the dynamic range is quite good. The front camera can tend to have a bit of airbrush effect to it, but this only happens in low light. But yeah, let's move on to the elephant in the room, and that's the fact that this guy doesn't come with Google mobile services. Instead, Huawei is using Huawei mobile services, and what this does is that it replaces all the things that you'd miss on Google mobile services, one of which is the Play Store. Now, there's no Google Play Store on the Y7P. Instead, Huawei is using App Gallery. And guys, just to give you a bit of perspective, yeah, Huawei has actually invested about $15 billion into all of this, and right now the App Gallery has over 40,000 applications. So you can find a number of popular applications like Snapchat, TikTok and the likes, but there are also certain applications that are not there yet. For example, Instagram is not there at the moment, Facebook is not also there. But guys, that's not even a problem, because you can always install these applications from third-party platforms like APK Mirror or APK Todd. Now, with that said, as far as the App Gallery is concerned, Huawei has done a couple of things to sweeten the port. For example, they've been able to integrate a feature where you can easily change your country to another country so that you can access all the applications that are popular in that said country. Right, there's also the fact that Huawei has integrated like a reward-based system. So for example, for the App Gallery in United Kingdom, Huawei is currently doing like a sort of reward-based system where you can play a game and win the Huawei P40. So yeah, that is that. But moving on to other things that Huawei mobile services have replaced, and yeah, there's the fact that, you know, there's no Gmail, instead you get Huawei Mail. There's no Google Play Music, instead you get Huawei Music. There's no Google Translate, instead Huawei is integrating their translator. Now, there are some things that you can't get, right? For example, you can't get applications that heavily rely on Google Play services, one of which is YouTube. So I was able to install YouTube on the Y7P, but I couldn't run it. And to solve this, you can either go to the browser, that's Huawei's internet browser, and just input youtube.com and watch your videos, or you could download a third-party YouTube app. But surprisingly, I was able to install other Google applications like Google Maps and Google Chrome, but the only thing is that I couldn't sign in. So to a large extent, there's nothing you're looking for on the Y7P that you can't get an alternative to. However, if you're not tech savvy, it might take some time getting used to the old ecosystem. At the end of the day, if you're looking to get this guy, then it means that you're going to invest in Huawei's ecosystem. And if there's anybody that can take on Google, aside from Apple, then it's Huawei. So yeah, let me know what you think about the whole idea of Huawei mobile services and all of that. And please do subscribe, like this video, and I'll see you in my next one.